Hi, everyone. It's Matt Reiners, co-founder of Eversound, and I am joined today by my friend Leslie Elbaback Powell, a certified dementia practitioner, regional director of sales and marketing, and also a regional lifestyle coordinator for Milestone Retirement. Before I ask when you sleep, Leslie, for all those things that you're responsible for, I want to thank you for joining us here today.
Thank you so much for having me, Matt. It's great to see you.
You as well. And we'll jump right into it. I know one of the buzz topics slash conversations, almost to the point where I feel like every article we see now is around occupancy. And I'm curious, how have you and Milestone Retirement communities responded to occupancy challenges over the last year?
Well, it's a challenge. It's a great question. We've got a lot of different communities and a lot of different regions, and I think it's been a different sort of challenge for each of us. I think having a very, very thoughtful approach to not trying to open too quickly, not trying to do too much too quickly, and maintain the standards so that we can maintain the safety of our residents, I think has been paramount. Really just taking the time, since we had the time, to really think about what that needs to look like and how we're going to help our families understand that it can be a safe process and it can be mutually beneficial, and that it still is a good thing to move into a congregate setting. I think that all those things just kind of have played out very thoughtfully and slowly, and just trying to be as conscientious as we can and communicating all the things that we're doing at community levels to make sure that our residents are safe and cleaning protocols. And, you know, I'm sure it's the same for everybody who's out there in this industry. It's really trying to be thoughtful and not get ahead of ourselves and not try to do too much too fast, but also try to make sure that we keep moving forward.
Of course. Hey, that's all we can do, right? Is just keep moving forward.
Exactly.
And you know, you talk about the families and some of the potential residents, and I'm curious if there's any new policies or procedures that you found to be like the most impactful, you know, in really maintaining or providing that family or potential resident or your current residents' satisfaction within your community today.
So I think obviously having to shut our doors and not have our families come in to be with us has been extremely traumatic. And it's been not just a traumatic for the families, not just traumatic for the residents, but traumatic for the staff as well. For a lot of our communities, our families are one of the biggest reasons we're successful. They're with us and they get to see us and they get to see what we do and how we do it. And they're another layer of support. And they know our residents better than anybody. And so really helping us stay connected. So when we had to shut everybody out, it was pretty devastating, and it's been pretty devastating. And I think really getting ahead of the communication and making sure that we are over communicating with families has been one of the things that's proven most helpful and helped the families through this process too. Even though they've been in our community, they know how we do things, they know how it works. Everything that you saw in the news, everything that you saw everywhere that was happening, it was like our families are sitting home, they're locked in their houses and they're watching the TV and they're seeing all these things. And even if they know that that's not who we are, the panic is there, the fear is there, because we're still a congregate setting. We still have, you know, a lot of things to try to do to keep our residents safe. And just really having that solid communication, just constantly letting them know as things change. And sometimes that was all the time. You know, we get different feedback from CDC and Department of Health and the state level and the federal level and just everything kind of bombarding. And really trying to maintain this is what's happening in our moment right here with us right now. And this is what we need from you and what we can do to help you build that bridge so that you can stay connected to us. So this year has been all about learning.
Yeah, no, it makes total sense. And it seems, you know, it's a recurring theme, right? We watch what's going on in the news, but having and over communicating seems to be a really big theme in some of my other conversations as well. Because it really seems like the families are more involved than ever. And really, you know, I would think on the level of care too, whether it's, you know, helping mom or dad move into a place or helping them to look at different options. And since the families are more involved, and I think you're amazing with individuals and with family members, you know, how do you think communities can capitalize on this, you know, with families being more involved? And how do you think Milestone and your team are handling changing expectations?
So I think showing up when we can, with embracing different technologies, with looking at things differently, the way that we handle our communications in the communities. You know, a lot of our receptionists and our activities team members, our concierge positions, turned into family comms managers. You know, they spent their days for months just setting up phone calls, setting up Zoom calls, setting up FaceTimes, embracing those technologies. And that is a learning curve, you know, whether it's for families or entertainers or however we could figure out to keep our people connected and not being afraid to try those new things, you know, because it's scary. And it's funny, the industry, I think, is very resistant to change, or has been for a lot of years. And this has forced us to kind of jump into that next decade, I guess, yeah, you know, and embrace a lot of the things that are out there, and really having to be flexible more than ever, because we're rolling with the changes that are coming our way. So being flexible, using the tools that we had and adding whatever tools we could, you know, whether it's an app that we have for the family communications, you know, we have two different ones that Milestone offers to their communities. Alpine makes an app called Quilt, and Sagely has an app that they include the calendars and the menus. Obviously, engaging Eversound has been a part of that and increasing the meaningfulness and the ability to communicate with our loved ones and have it be a meaningful experience, and being able to see our residents get the positives out of it that they really needed, and the families too, just the feedback we've gotten from a lot of that. So as frustrating as it's been, and as hard and difficult and challenging as it's been, it's also had huge payoffs, because we've been able to reinforce with our families that we are there for them, we are there for their loved ones, and we're going to do whatever it is that we can to make all of that work for everybody.
Right. And that's what it's all about, right? You know, being in it for the right reasons, trying to help improve one person's quality of life, getting them meaningful experiences, and trying to involve the family and keep them in the know at least, you know, and it seems like you guys are doing some awesome, awesome things with that. And you talk about like the technology adoption and going into the next decade here, which definitely, you know, I think senior living notoriously moves a little slow when it comes to technology, but everyone's kind of have to dive in with two feet or dive in head first. And have you experienced or seen any challenges in terms of like this expedited tech adoption?
It's really funny. I think one of the biggest hurdles that we had wasn't necessarily the residents, but the staff just automatically assuming that our residents couldn't do it. And I think that learning has been I think it feels the best, I guess. I don't know how else to put it, but when we assume that our residents can't, and we find oftentimes that they can, and it's humbling for us as the professionals to be reminded that we shouldn't be making these assumptions about the people that we serve. We really shouldn't be underestimating this population. This population has done so much in their lifetime, has done so much for this country. They really are an impressive generation, period. And so I think the challenges are with just people making assumptions. And the ones who embraced it right out of the gate, they're just running with it and they're having a ball and everything's going great. The other ones that took a little bit longer, they're catching on and now they're having more fun with it. And it's taken a little bit of time, but it definitely is a positive, I think, for everybody.
Yeah, no, makes sense. And, you know, I won't say the saying what happens when you assume, because I'm trying to keep this PG. But, you know, it's, and I've heard that time and time again, and I'm always blown away when I go into some of these communities, or when I, you know, could go into them. Hopefully I'll be back and more here soon. But just like the level of experience and expertise, and just like I've been in places with Eversound where I come to find out one of the residents is a formal electrical engineer and he's asking me questions about things. And I'm like, oh my goodness. I didn't think about it like that. So it is just wild to see. And I think, when we have more faith and more trust that, hey, why not try it? Right. And then, exactly. Just trying to see, you know, the pros outweigh the cons, and the cons really just seem like lack of use, but hey, you don't know it until you try.
Exactly. And I think you're right. Why not? And I think if we can take the word no out of our vocabulary at the community levels and really create a yes culture where why not is the word of the day or the phrase of the day, I think that we can do a lot more. And there's so many great things happening in this industry, and there's so many great communities that are embracing it and just running with it. I think it's definitely, this put us ahead of the game. I think we've been pushed into a place where we didn't have a choice. And so I'm thankful for it. I'm thankful that we're here because, you know, the headphones thing, you know, using Eversound, it's another task. It's another job. It's another, I have to be there 10 minutes early. I have to plan. I have to think about it, which is hard if you're just used to just moving, keeping things moving, go, go, go. But when you take the time and you stop and you do it, and you see the benefit of it, it's like, holy cow, why haven't we been doing this the entire time? Because the benefit to the resident is so extreme and so life-changing and meaningful that it's like, I'm kicking myself. Why didn't we do this forever ago? And so I'm thankful for organizations like Eversound, organizations like Sagely and like Alpine, who are working so hard to get all of these apps and all of these things out into the world. It's just amazing. And we are ready for it and embracing it more than ever. So it's exciting.
Yeah. And I'm big fans of Sagely, and I'll have to get to know Alpine. I don't know them quite well enough yet, but, and I think it kind of goes into like how we work together. Right. And it's not like just trying to be a vendor and just, you know, sell you something, say good luck and never talk to you again, but really partnering together, getting feedback from people like you and the heroes on your team that are on the front lines, what's working, what's not working, so we can ultimately work together to improve that quality of life, because that's why we're all in it to begin with.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Awesome. So in closing, if you could just sum up, you know, the three main takeaways that other providers can learn from you or your experience or your expertise, you know, on helping to manage those family and resident expectations. And, you know, how does that translate to the bottom line in their community?
I would say communicate. I don't know if I have anything to offer anybody that's going to be brand new to anyone, but communicating with our families has saved us so much heartache and stress. If we wait for them to come to us, it's way too late. We need to be outwardly communicating. We need to be honest with our families. We need to be as educating as we can be, because we're the experts. We're the ones who are supposedly in control of, you know, keeping everything going the way it's supposed to be going. And I think if we don't have confidence in being in that position and share that education and help our families understand and help other people understand, it's not just our families, people in the community that just make assumptions and don't know because they haven't dealt with it and they haven't been there yet. And everybody's going to be eventually. So I think the education piece and the communication piece, being as open and honest as you can about the process and what we need from our families to help support us and get through it, those are the things that I would say have been the game changers for us.
Need to give you a microphone so you can drop it after that. That was great. Awesome, Leslie. Well, this has been great. I want to thank you so much for spending some time out of your busy day with us here today. And until next time.
Thank you so much, Matt. It's great to see you. Have a great rest of your day.
Awesome. Thank you, Leslie.
Bye.